Hey, good morning. My name's Tony from A&E Construction. You're watching Build with A&E, and today we're going to show you how to put chemical resin anchor bolts into a concrete footing. So the stages that we're doing at the moment, this is a finished product, as you can see. The next phase before that is then actually chemically anchoring the bolts in and then setting the studs. Process then before that is actually drilling the holes with the SDS drill into each point. First process is actually cutting your pocket, which we've done now. So what I'm going to do now is I'll show you the process of the drilling and then putting the chemical resin compound in to allow us then to put the bolts in and then put the plate in as well at the same time. So now we set the steels in the temporary positions and we've got them supported with blues. So it allows us then to set each of the steel plates out. So now we set this steel in, we've butted this temporary steel plate into here. You can see it's supported with the blue brick underneath there. So what we're going to do now is going to use the SDS and we're going to drill four pilot holes there just to get it started. Okay, so I literally piloted the holes with this 12mm SDS, just a little bit easier than trying to use the 14mm bit. So let's swap it over. Now the reason I'm using 14mm, because that's what's been specified by the engineer, and also the size of the bolt that we're using. I've also put a bit of black tape on the drill, as you can see here. And what that represents the top of my footing here, to then the full depth I've got to drill, because the engineer has specified that we have to be 110mm down into the concrete. So with what the distance we've got from here to the top of where we've cut into this put in, and then obviously then the 110 is the distance of 210mm, which is here. In this process, the chemical resin that we're using is called Raw Plug RKF2. It's a polyester resin. You can pick this up from any local merchant. We actually pick this up from Juicens. On the back here, it says once you've cut the end off here, you have to then pump the gun through until all the chemical has come out the other end and it's fully mixed. And with this, the chemical is in two colors, a very light cream and a dark gray. So you can actually see the chemical mixed together. But also on the back here, it says that you have to use a blower. You have to use this twice and you have to blow into the hole four times. And then you have to then use the brush. You have to push the brush in and out four times. That's what the directions on the back of the tube are, but we don't actually do that. We actually probably do that about three or four times, times four. And then we also do this then four or five times, times four, five. And then we use the Hoover as well because we like to make sure it's really, really clean, but you'll see the process now. Hoover there. And then give it a brush out. You probably noticed I've done it more than four times. There we go. And then give it another blow. See how much more comes out. That extra last bit of dust in that hole has been pushed down to the bottom of the hole by the brush. Give it another hoover. Now I could actually stop there if I wanted to, but I prefer to give it another couple of brushes. Just giving this resin the best chance of keying to this footing. Yeah, last bits. Give it one quick hoover. Now, the one thing I do like to do is, as I'm working on each hole, I do like to put a little bit of plastic in the hole, like that. Stops any further dust going down and stops it getting contaminated by any dust. So we'll move on to the next hole. You notice there's a lot more dust around this hole. So instead of me brushing it, I'm actually going to do an extra hoover just to get that little bit of extra dust off. And now I can start my brush, as you see, working around the hole, twisting it around as well, up and down, get it really good, well in there.
set. Not so much dust this time. Pump on again. Hoover again. Get a final brush. Final bump. There we go. I'm really happy with that now. So I'll get myself another bit of plastic. Stick it in the hole. There we go. Move on to the next one. Good brush again. With a pump out. You'd be amazed when you think that you've got it all, and then look, all these little bits come out, and you think you've got it all. And like, this is the second time I've pumped now. So that's why we go a little bit over the top when we do the pumping and obviously the cleaning out with the brush. It's just that. So it's the third time I look, see the bits come out? Third time now. There we go. Starting to get a bit happy with this hole now. So it's the third time now I've done this. Whereas the recommendation says once and then twice on the pump, but as you can see, it's quite important to spend the extra little bit of time and effort to clean the holes out really well, because then you know you've got the best possible fixing. Let's see if any more come up. A little bit, I haven't anything now, I'm a lot happy with that now. So, get the last hoover off. Getting a bit of plastic again. Sticks them in the hole. Right, the final hole now. That's it, a bit of another pump. Yeah, more dust come out. Last bit of hoover. The last bit in. So, I'm now ready to start doing my chemical. Resin.
You can actually buy them in the smaller tubes now, so instead of buying like this chem gun, and this is a silver line product actually, and you can buy these from Juicens as well, so wherever you buy this from, you'll be able to buy this gun at the same time. But they do actually now, they do this in a smaller tube, but we always buy the bigger tubes because it's a lot more cost effective, which is really important.
Probably worth saying as well, they don't come with the nozzles. You have to buy the nozzles separately now as well.
Yes, do. Ah, right, there you go then. So you can see, at the end of the gun, you've got the darker resin, and then obviously the center part, which has got the lighter resin. So as you then pump with this face and then this face, the two chemicals which are inside this tube will then mix together. Now the other thing is that it's got temperatures of drying times. So in other words, if it's like 20 Celsius, it takes processing time is 5 minutes then, but the actual main curing time is 45 minutes. And obviously depending on the weather conditions, you can read all of the substrate temperatures and the temperatures outside to adhere as well, so it gives you an idea how long it's going to take for the resin to go off. And the weather conditions today, I would think probably within an hour and a half it will be where we want it to be, so we can actually work on the steels and actually bolt the plates down. Right, okay, so now primed and prepped it, ready to go. We've got about half a tube in here, and I think with the amount of chemical we've got to do, we'll probably need another tube. Have we got another tube?
We have.
Awesome. So what we're going to do is we're going to prep another tube. So we're going to get that sorted out first, and then we're going to take all the posts out. Once we take all the posts out, we're then going to go along with this tube and the new tube, put it into all the holes, put all of our threaded bar into each of those, and then set them with the posts, and then we'll then pull the posts out, and then we can lock everything off. So you'll see that process now. I've taken all the plastic bits out of each of the holes. So the next process is to squeeze the resin into each of the holes. I'm gonna do all of these 12 holes in one hit. You'll see the process as we're doing it. With this gun, because we've already primed it already, because we've already used half the tube, I don't need to worry about this repriming itself. So as you see, as I'm pushing it through, you can see it mixing. It's already pre-mixed. You see there, look, you see all the black in there already. It's already mixed. So, what do you reckon, John? It's good, that is, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good.
So what we're gonna do now is fill the hole completely. There you go, look, you see all going in.
So once I've done that, I then get my bolts, which I've prepped earlier, and I actually just twist them in nice and slowly until it bottoms out. That's it. Once I've got it set, wipe the excess off. So just keep twisting it in, threading it in. I'm using these nuts to hold the plate off so the plate doesn't stick to the resin. So just wipe it back a bit. There we go. So next thing, get my metal post. And what I'm going to do then is put the post in before the resin goes off. If John, my camera guy, can give me a bit of a hand for locating your bolts. There we go. As I said to you earlier, I've got my blues here, so to make sure I've got my plates in the right place. There we go. On to the next hole. You can see when we plumb all this up, it's a little bit off the line at the moment, but when we plumb all that up, because at the moment this post isn't plumb, we know that's going to kick to the right, but you'll see that in another process. So I'm just going to put some more chem into here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the other four holes now. Ran out. So there's my new nozzle. So what we're going to do is, with a bit of rubbish now, you'll see it mixing together. Look, you see the two mixing together. So we'll squeeze it through. See it now coming through. So there you go, that's the colour we're after. You see it there? That's lovely. Exactly that now. That's, we know it's mixing beautifully. So now, lock that up. So I'm going to fill these two up. Like that, there you go. Is that one filled? Fill from the bottom up, work up. Push the tube other down, fill from the bottom, work all the way up. Just stops any air, trapped air, all the way down to the bottom of the hole. Work your way up nice and slowly. That's it, because then you get no air in there. That's it, once I've finished. Get these in. I like to screw them in like that, because if you force and push them in, it will just push the resin out and then put a huge air pocket in there. So now I'm not going to wipe this one too much, because I know these nuts are higher than the resin, which is really good. Okay, so all the resin anchor has been put in. As you can see, we've got a timber that to keep all these steel straight. We've used as a temporary all the individual cross member transoms that are going to be going in at a higher level. But what that does, it makes sure the spacing is correct. And then the other last check is then this string line at the back here. That string line all the way along the back is our line, and that's absolutely perfect all the way along, because it's really key. That's where we need it all lining through, so it's not wavy.
Hit the like button if you like the video, and then subscribe at the same time. That'd be great. And then see you on the next video. Bye bye.